we're going to go into our interview for the day. That is trail running. Whether you're stuck in a running rut or bored of the normal street route or just plain hate the treadmill, it might be time to leave the road and head to the trails. There's a growing number of people who are now participating in trail running, which is the sport that consists of running and hiking over trails. To talk more on this, we are joined by Shane Gouldie as well as Bernie Rue from Trail Running Adventure. Remember, you can join in the discussion by calling us at 011-537-9337 or 9338 or commenting on our Facebook and Twitter accounts. Guys, thank you so much for coming through this morning. Now, Shane, we know about the road riding, we know about cross country, all that kind of thing. Trail running, what's the difference? Well, what is different about trail running?
Well, there isn't much of a difference except that it's much more enjoyable. It's kind of like a drug, you know. You get out there in the open, in the bush. We're doing it on golf courses to establish the first part of the trail running program. And then from there, you can run in the bush. From there, you can go into the mountains. And eventually, you can become a trail runner that runs for 100Ks, like these crazy oaks, like next to me, Benny, where they run for 17 hours, 24 hours, overnights, two-day stages, and things like that. But the big thing is that trail running now is an official sport in the world. It was recognized in Beijing in June. And in South Africa, we've been doing trail running for a long time, but now it's an official sport. And the good thing about that, well, we know from cricket and soccer and things like that, we want our youngsters to become South African athletes, and we want them to be recognized by South African sport. And this is now a golden opportunity. And this is the great thing, having guys like Benny, who's a role model for youngsters, getting involved in the sport, and we're getting those youngsters running on the golf courses, doing night runs and things like that, and a little bit of an introduction to trail running, because a golf course is not really the most difficult place to run on, but there is bumps and things like that, so it gives the youngsters an idea, and the older guys an idea of what trail running can be. So it's really an introduction to trail running, and then they can get into the big stuff. We usually have that in the winter because it's too hot now to do trail running. So we have it in the winter where we have our two-stage races in places like in Lesotho and in the Drakensberg Mountains and Machubuskloof, all these beautiful places in South Africa. So it's quite exciting to all those people that were doing hiking in the days where you have a five-day hike. The only difference, we just run it in one day. So it sounds crazy, but I think you have to be
a little 5 days worth of sightseeing in one day.
Yeah.
Benny, I mean, on your part, being a trail runner, running, I mean, you were telling me that you just finished a 100-kilometer race. That's pretty much a comrades in the mountains. Yes. What is that like?
Yes, that's just a bit more extreme. Comrades, by now, you can almost run if your eyes closed or like that other guy, run it backwards. In trail running, that's just not possible. We're running, we did an elevation of over 5,500 meters. So you really go up and down the mountains quite a couple of times.
Now you were telling me a bit, well, like, okay, you actually go through a lot, your body takes a knock. You were saying you even had to stop for an hour where your body had to regain its heat to recover. I mean, it's quite a dangerous sport in itself as well.
It is quite dangerous. I, at one stage, thought I was dying and then almost got disappointed that I was not dying, and the medic actually he wrapped us in space blankets and we got our body back and we carried on.
Now, maybe on your part, Shane, the growth of the sport, I mean, you said now it's just been internationally recognized as an official sport. In South Africa, what is it like? Is it at that level where it's being recognized as an official sport? How what's the participation like in South Africa?
Well, we've already chatted to South African sport, and they're very keen to get trail running becoming fully fledged and really well organized. In South Africa, it's very, very popular. In our company now, we've just started it, and we can't believe the growth already. We've gone from 100, 200 runners to over 95, 600 runners. And in actual fact, we've got too many runners now, so it's very, very popular. And the nice thing, Mark, about it is that you can go, you can take your family. It's a family participation sport because the family comes there. They can run in a safe destination. It's at night. They've got music and the big vibe and food and drinks and all that kind of stuff. And it's a really a family night out. But you know, to carry on from that, I think if you look at Spain and Italy and Europe and even in the Americas with the 100 milers and that, and by the way, Benny's doing a 100 miler, that's 160 Ks in May. So if you go overseas, it's a lot bigger than South Africa. I'm doing a race in the Canary Islands, a race called Transvolcania. It's also 100 kilometers, but there you have about 19,000 spectators. So I think if you take mountain biking, which took over from road cycling, I have no doubt that in 5-10 years' time, you'll find that trail running would have taken over from road running.
Now, Shane speaks about 160 kilometers, that's the 100 miler. I mean, doing things like that, when I think about that, I'm thinking, okay, maybe over 2 or 3 days. You're going to do that in one day?
It's one go, yes.
I mean, how do you prepare your body for something like that?
I don't know.
Chocolate,
lots of coffee. You don't think about it. You just do it.
It's just something you do.
Yeah.
So, would you consider this an extreme sport? Is this considered, because you know you got all these extreme sports with the mountain, where the motorcycles doing flips through the air and all the different kind of things? Would you consider trail running an extreme sport?
Yeah, definitely.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Now, Shane, in terms of where the sport is going in South Africa, do you see this becoming an Olympic sport? Like you're saying, it will 5 or 10 years, it'll grow that much more. Will this eventually become an Olympic sport?
I have no doubt it will become an Olympic sport. Especially if the Olympics are in Europe, and that trail running is huge. It's going to take a few years. And I think South Africa is probably one of the best destinations in the world. If you look at our climate, we have brilliant climate in South Africa. We have the mountains, we have the people, and I think it's like we always chat about cricket development, soccer development, rugby development. We're going to have a program where we're going to develop the youngsters. We're going to start them on the golf courses with the dad. Benny's a classic example. His son runs with him in the night races. His son makes sure he goes to our races because his son loves running at night. He loves running on the golf courses. So that's where we're starting. We're starting at the youth, getting those youngsters involved. And I have no doubt that trail running is going to become huge in the world and in South Africa.
So your son is following in your footsteps then?
Yes.
He's definitely going to be a trail runner as well?
Definitely.
Rashid, I was asking you, just tell us in short, maybe, like, where can people go to get involved in trail running? I mean, it's not something that is out in the open, it's not well publicized, I mean, we haven't heard too much about it. Where can people go to start off?
Well, I've got a website called Trail Adventure. All the races are on that website. You can just Google trail running and you'll find there's a lot of companies involved in running different trails in Gauteng, in Cape Town, all over. It's huge in Cape Town, trail running. So there's a lot of, every weekend you can find it somewhere where there's a trail run. So it's not as though it's only run by our company. There's lots of companies out there running it. And we want to support all those companies because the more companies that are involved, the more
it's about the growth of this
opportunity. That's all we're interested in at the moment, is developing the sport.
No, definitely. Guys, thanks for your time, and definitely something to look forward to. That was Shane Gouldie as well as Benny Roo from Trail Running Adventure telling us more about the sport of trail running. We go straight to an ad break now, but stay tuned, Sunrunner, there's more in store for you.